Hello and thank you for watching TwoCarPros.com. In this video, we're going to show you how to replace the front brake pads and rotors on a 2004 to 2008 Acura TL. Let's start with suspending the front end with the e-brake on, allowing us to remove the front wheel. Turning the rotor assembly can help you when doing this repair. Using the appropriate size metric socket and wrench, remove the brake caliper slide bolts. Our next step is to remove the brake caliper. Find a spot to rest the caliper. Do not allow the caliper to hang from the brake line. Using a standard screwdriver, remove the old brake pads. You can see here that our brake pads are worn, needing to be replaced. Remove the old brake pad retainer clips from the brake caliper mounting bracket. Our next step is to remove the two caliper mounting bracket bolts using the appropriate size metric socket wrench. Using an impact screwdriver, remove the two mounting hardware screws holding the rotor to the brake assembly. Using the appropriate size metric hardware, remove the rotor from the brake assembly. We like to compare our new brake rotor to our old brake rotor to be sure a proper install. Using breaker carb cleaner, clean the surface in which the brake pads will be mating to. Next step is to install the rotor back to the vehicle, making sure to line up the mounting hardware screws, seen here. Install and tighten the mounting hardware screws you removed from before. Then install the caliper mounting bracket using the two mounting hardware bolts you removed from before, and tighten using the appropriate size metric socket wrench. Install the upper and lower brake pad retainer clips. We like to compare our new brake pads with our old brake pads to be sure a proper install. Our next step is to install the new brake pads to the brake caliper mounting bracket. Make sure to get the correct orientation of the brake pad. The one with the metal tang goes to the inside. We will need to compress the brake caliper piston back into the brake caliper. We like to use an old brake pad and a large pair of channel locks, but you can also use a brake caliper compression tool. Before installing the brake caliper to the brake assembly, check the brake caliper slides to see if they need to be greased. If they need no grease, install the brake caliper back to the brake assembly and tighten using the appropriate size metric socket and wrench. Install the wheel back onto the car, and then hand tighten the lug nuts to avoid cross threading, and then tighten the lug nuts in a cross pattern formation. Once the vehicle is on the ground, torque the lug nuts to factory specifications. Before operating the vehicle, you will need to press down on the brake pedal slowly, and then release the brake pedal slowly, repeating this process until you have found what is called brake pressure, then the vehicle is safe to drive. Please click our subscribe button and like us on Facebook. Thank you for watching 2carpros.com.